starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
Lassie, what's going on?
Careful, that's a prize specimen.
Timmy, I think your insect collection for school is just fine, but not when you get your bugs all over the house.
Well, gee whiz, Mom, they escaped.
I think I'll do the same.
I tore my pants on the barbed wire catching that one.
Timmy, this is quite a collection.
I'm just starting, Dad. There's all kinds of bugs. Big ones, little ones, good ones, bad ones. And some can fly and some can't.
One favor, would you please keep them all nice and safe in their jars?
Oh, Mom, they're more scared of you than you are of them.
You want to bet?
Look. Aesop's story of the grasshopper and the ant.
Research. For my bug project. When you read about bugs, it's called research.
And the Bible, Timmy, how are you using that?
Well, there's stories in there about the locust. The locust is another kind of a grasshopper.
Of course. The locust plagues.
The Sunday school teacher told me about it when she found out I was working with bugs.
Well, Timmy, grasshoppers can do plenty of damage. They can eat every growing thing on a farm.
Why don't they just stick to spinach?
Well, there isn't enough. Little boys eat it all.
Ugh. Mom, did you ever read the story of the grasshopper and the ant?
Oh, yes. Let's see, the grasshopper plays every day all summer long, while the ant works hard gathering food for the cold winter days when there isn't any.
Right. And then the grasshopper starves because he didn't work.
Well, I guess Mr. Aesop was trying to teach us that a person should plan for the future.
Well, one of the ways we can start planning for the future right now is to get in bed and get some sleep. There you go.
Lassie, if any of them get out tonight, you let me know.
I've got a feeling she'll let us all know.
Night, dear.
Night, Mom.
Good night, son.
Night, Dad. You better close the door.
Oh, don't worry, I will.
If any of them get out, they'll stay in here with us. Sorry, Lassie. Pretty noisy, huh?
Much danger of that, Timmy. There'll always be a lot of grasshoppers around.
Can we please talk about something else during supper?
Can only explain to Dad.
Well, you can tell him afterward.
I've got a Grange meeting to go to tonight.
But if you go to the Grange meeting, we won't have time to talk.
I'll tell you what I'll do, son. If it's all right with your mother, you can come to the Grange meeting with me. You know, it wouldn't hurt him to listen in on some farm talk for a while. Besides, it'll give us a little time together.
Can I go, Mom? Can I?
Well, if your father doesn't think it'll be too late, I guess it's all right.
Yippee! Did you hear that, Lassie? I get to go to the Grange meeting, just like a man. And you stay here and take care of Mom.
You see, Timmy, grasshoppers are no different from any other kind of bug. They come with a season, and at the end of the summer, they die off.
But you said grasshoppers could eat every growing thing on a farm.
Well, they can, if there's an invasion.
You mean like the plague we read about in the Bible?
About the same. Don't you worry, Timmy, there isn't going to be any plague. Our crops are quite safe, even if you did see a lot of grasshoppers.
Well, then, we're all agreed that we go to work on the county for more gravel on the old mill road, huh?
Absolutely, Silas. One good rain and the gravel that is on it now will disappear in the mud.
All right, then. The committee, Jed and Dan, will make a call on the county road commissioner. Well, let's see. Guess that's everything on the agenda. Anybody got anything else particular on his mind?
I'd like to say something. Well, I've been studying about insects lately, and a farm's a good place for it, because you have so many. And today I saw some grasshopper eggs and some baby grasshoppers, millions of them, more than I ever saw before. And in all the books my teacher's given me, that means we've got trouble.
Well, go on, son.
Well, when I saw those baby grasshoppers and those eggs, well, I think we should do something about it.
Now, in my opinion, that was a mighty fine speech. You can be proud of that boy, Paul.
I guess this is pretty important to him.
Tain't every young fellow that takes that much interest in what's going on his farm. Well, anybody else?
Well, I just thought you might be interested to know the price of feed's going up. Might be a good idea to stock up ahead.
Well, you all heard Dan Porter. When you get your bills, you can't say he didn't warn you. Well, I'll get on the mill road project first thing in the morning. Meeting's adjourned.
I'm sure glad you aren't angry at me, Dad.
Come on now, dear. You've talked about it enough for tonight. You did what you thought was right, and that's all anybody could expect of you.
Night, Mom.
I was very proud of you tonight, Timmy. But worrying about the farm is my job, at least until you're a little bit older. Look, Ruth, why don't we take a couple of hours off tomorrow afternoon and go into Calverton? I've got to get some things, and you could find a shop to look around in, and Timmy could have himself an ice cream soda. How about that, son?
Did you hear that, girl?
Good night, dear.
Timmy, we'll meet you in the drugstore in a half hour.
Okay, Dad. No, Lassie. You come with me. We're not going to the drugstore yet. I've got something more important to do. You stay here, Lassie. Morning, Mr. Porter.
Well, hello there, young man. After that speech last night, it won't be too long before you'll be hanging up your lawyer's shingle.
Thank you.
Well, now, what can I do for you?
Well, there's some things I need. Grasshopper poison bait. The kind that's water soluble? Yeah, that's it. And then some spraying powder.
I see you convinced your dad we're going to have grasshopper trouble.
No, sir. This order's for me. I'm paying for it.
Well,
I know we're going to have grasshopper trouble, and I want us to be ready.
Mm-hmm. A large sack of spraying powder. Uh-huh. I'll have to check the price on that. And a 5-gallon drum of poison bait. That'll come to
$31.07. $21.07.
Mr. Porter, how are you?
Hello, Mrs. Martin. Hi, Paul. Your son's turning into quite a farmer, but I'm afraid he's a little short of cash to buy the stuff he'll need to fight those grasshoppers.
I thought sure my spending money and that quarter you gave me would be enough.
Where'd you get this information from, Timmy?
I copied it out of my encyclopedia.
Well, you better go ahead and fill Timmy's order, Dan. One more thing, Timmy. We might need a flamethrower. Do you suppose you could rent us one for about a week, Dan?
Oh, sure. I always keep one on hand for emergencies. And that'll be a few dollars more.
Okay.
But what if I'm wrong, Dad? All that money will be wasted.
No, it won't, Timmy. We can use that poison bait and spray dust to get rid of any other bugs and insects we want to. And if we don't use the flamethrower for grasshoppers, we can use it to burn off the weeds with.
Why don't you go buy your ice cream soda now while Mr. Porter loads the pickup?
Gee, thanks.
General price trends are firm with a slow rise on eggs and butter fat. Weather conditions continue good. And now in closing, a general warning. There are scattered reports of grasshoppers throughout the county as well as from adjoining Franklin County. These reports seem to indicate a possibly heavy year for hoppers. I suggest you keep a close watch and take early precautions. Good morning.
Mom, Dad, did you hear that?
Paul, Timmy was right.
You certainly were, Timmy. And because you were, we're ready. You know, we're not going to wait for the reports to get any worse. We'll start right now. And I'll begin with that batch of hoppers that you found in the field yesterday, Timmy.
And then last night, I'll find some more.
We need some organization now, Timmy. You and Lassie show me where they are, and then you can start hunting for others.
Okay, Dad.
Ruth, you follow me in the pickup, huh?
All right.
Timmy. You and Lassie go find some more, huh? Well, he found some. Keep back when I use this, huh?
We better get out of here. What'd you do that for? I'm sorry, Lassie. I should have known you'd have a reason. A good reason. Little deers always hide out like this. Your mother told him to. Until she gets back. But if he stays here, he'll get killed by the fire. It's moving fast. I'm gonna carry you out of here, and then your mother will find you. Honest, she will. Boy, you're sure heavy. It's no use, I can't lift you. Maybe you can walk. I guess you're too scared to walk. Lassie, you'll have to get Dad. Go get Dad, Lassie. Go get Dad.
I'll get the tractor and run the disc over those fires, make sure they're out.
It's all right, girl. You just stay here. It's okay. We'll get you out. Honest. It's okay.
Well, we'll pick up Timmy on the way back.
Oh, look, Paul, there's some smoke over there.
Yeah, probably brush burning. We better go see.
I'm worried about Timmy. We better hurry.
I'll cut a path through. You follow me. Here and put the rest of these fires out.
Oh, Paul, please be careful.
I will.
Move over, Lassie. Come on. Where do you suppose his mother is?
Looking for her baby, no doubt.
I wonder if she's worried about him.
That's the way mothers are. They always worry about their young.
See? I told you everything would be all right. Lassie, you saved that little fawn's life. And you helped save our farm from finding those grasshoppers. Right, Mom?
Right.
Well, I've been on the phone talking to some of the others. Jed Ransom was hit pretty hard.
Oh, dear. I'm sorry to hear that.
Tomorrow I'm going to take the tractor over and start plowing for him. He'll have time to put in some of his crops again.
Dad, is it all right if I go? I want to help, too. Me and Lassie.
Yeah, of course you can go with me.
When does Timmy have to give his report on insects at school? I'd like to attend in person.
We'll both go.